It is impossible to offer others what we lack ourselves. Think about it. If we are not capable of feeling love for ourselves, it will be hard for us to have a healthy relationship with others. Loving yourself is the first step towards developing trust and stability with another person. Loving yourself means giving yourself the chance to discover the great potential and greatness that you hold within. It means being honest with yourself and committing to your well-being. Furthermore, loving oneself also implies being alert to one's own needs. It means to respect, accept and love yourself for who you are. When we stop judging, criticizing and comparing ourselves to others, when we stop forcing ourselves to be anyone other than who we are, we dismantle the preconceived ideas that we had about ourselves. Ideas which determine our life and keep us from meeting an important and valuable part of our being. In order to be at peace with ourselves, we have to stop demanding more from ourselves than we really are. Aspiring to be better in life and as people is an indisputable project that we all have to undertake. Yet, it should not lead us to a state of constant anxiety in which we end up despising our very essence. It's a must that we learn to let go of false beliefs which condition our present. Only in the present can we act and live fully. And although we may not have everything we dreamt, we have the power to change that by living in accordance to who we are. Fantasizing about what the past once was and what the future could be only gets us away from reality. A reality which will never be just like the one we dreamt, but at least it's real. Learning to love oneself is an endless journey that will present itself to us in many forms. But healthy self-evaluation is the first step towards self-knowledge. We have to learn to think in a more adjusted way, leaving aside excessive criticism and unreachable perfectionism. The attributions that we give ourselves condition our self-esteem. We attribute all of the achievements we have accomplished to external factors such as luck or chance. If we attribute all our failures to our inner characteristics, our self-esteem will suffer. Due to which type of unjust attribution with ourselves, we make it even harder for us to love ourselves. It has been said by Sally Field that it took me a long time to stop judging myself through the eyes of others. True love is not the physical or erotic kind. It means wanting the best for someone, putting yourself in their shoes. Sometimes, feelings of intense desire, admiration and emotional investment in another person hinder our understanding of love. Most of us at some point have confused what it means to love another person with possessing them or wanting to change them. In order to correctly love someone, we have to act based on altruistic ideas and behaviors. Love for another makes us want to contribute to the development of their skills, not the ones we wish they had. Seeking our happiness and feeling good about ourselves does not equate to being selfish. It is the most essential and important condition necessary in order to establish a positive relationship with others. Over time, we have realized that we can't blame others for not being the way we would like them to. And that's where the journey towards correctly loving others begins. Thank you.